Hey strangers, today I'd like to talk about a little incident that happened when me and a couple of mates went to a restaurant the other night. We were looking at the menu, I was trying to think, what could we actually order tonight? It's like, the pasta looks pretty good, and the steak. But I'm a guy who actually really likes the steak, so let's go with the steak. But I have to admit, beforehand, like actually going out, I was like really hungry, so I decided to have 20-piece feed of nuggets. But as you can imagine, the tempura nuggets are basically just beer battered pieces of chicken. So they do fill you up a fair bit. So keeping in mind for the story, I'm already pretty much full. But me liking my steak, I thought, let's order the steak anyway. Now, with this meal, it actually came with an entree of a Caesar salad. So, yep, rabbit food, whatever, supposed to be good for you, so you just eat that. The steak, it's like, yeah, I can knock this out. It's a simple steak. I'm a man. I can eat all this. I'm eating it, it's like, okay, this is good. I'll have this really steak. Yeah, I'm getting pretty full. Then we get about 3/4 way through the steak and what's going on? I have steak, but I don't want to eat it. The thing is, I've never not finished a steak, because I love steak. I've said that many times now. Not many, but enough to reinforce the fact I like steak. So my mind is focused the whole time saying, I'm gonna finish this. I don't care how long it takes, I'm gonna finish this. My god, just click it off. It's talking about steak. Yeah, it's the awkward part. My mate comes to me and says, oh, come on, Andy, you can finish that steak. There's starving children in Africa. Starving children in Africa? And I was trying to think, are those words of encouragement or not? Because the way you think about it, it's like, yes, there are starving children in Africa. And I have a whole steak in front of me. So, automatically you're gonna think, you should eat it. Because you know, those kids are starving. So naturally you should try, yeah, you should be grateful. And try and finish the steak you have in front of you. Because his face is delicious. And you just shouldn't waste food. Yeah, that's encouraging, so I should eat this. On the other hand, hang on a second. There are starving children in Africa, so wouldn't that mean that by me eating this steak, it's supposed to make me feel guilty because they're starving, and yet I'm filling myself with all this food that I can barely even finish, but I'm going to stuff myself with it anyway. So is that supposed to make me feel bad that I'm eating all this steak to the point that I can't even go on unless I loosen up my belt a little bit, and the children over there are starving? So, words of encouragement, words that are not so encouraging, they kind of blend in together, don't they, in this case? So, I guess suppose it's just the way your mind actually interprets things. Kind of the same way, like, you know how those pictures, looking at it one way and looking at it another way, you see two different things? Like, the one where you can see either a duck or a rabbit. In fact, I might draw it for you. You see it? Now, do you see a duck, or do you see a rabbit? Here's the bill, and there's the eye for the duck. Or, here's the eye, and here are the ears for the rabbit. I'm not quite sure what those pictures are called, but I'm sure if someone actually does know the name for those pictures, you can chuck them down in the comments and say, those things, the names of the pictures are... Yeah, and do that for me. Moving on to other business, the weather. You know, if in the UK it is snowing, half my subscriptions have been snow vlogs where everyone's dancing and vlogging in the snow. I'm not complaining, I love snow. Snowboarding's really fun. And so is skiing. It's snowing over in the UK. Over here in Australia, it's like a heat wave. People in Melbourne would know this because they are pretty much scorching at the moment. But the thing is, Melbourne, they're having the heat wave. Queensland's having flooding. And Sydney is getting hot. Because quite frankly, the heat wave is moving north to Sydney. Yes, this is a bad thing. However, the way you interpret things, okay? Personally, it doesn't really bother me. You know why? Because this Sunday, which is expected in Sydney to be a very high, what is it, around about 35 to 40 degrees in the city. That is bloody hot. And they also predicted that temperatures could reach highs of 47 degrees out in the west. which is absolutely crazy because I'm just flocked to the beach. That's my plan for everyone. Go to the beach if it's that hot. And just so happens that on Sunday, the day which Sydney is supposed to have a really hot temperature, I get to be flying down to Melbourne where it gets to be 10 degrees cooler. Coincidence? Maybe. Luck? Maybe. Coincidence. But the thing is, it's brilliant because exactly when I fly down there, the heat's moving up here. So, switch. Which makes it excellent gathering weather. But, and people here in Sydney get to enjoy nice beach weather because, let's face it, there's only 3 weeks left of summer and we just gotta enjoy as much heat as we can before we get to tuck ourselves in and enjoy marshmallows and Milo and Tim Tams and hibernating in all our little Duna covers and, well, I should say Australia's a lot more used to hot than it is cold. The whole point of this Melbourne trip is so that I can go and get a coffee and have some lunch at the Dolomite Cafe. And, yeah, other people are going to be there, you know, Ariel and a whole bunch of other Melbourne YouTubers. No, seriously. Dolomite, they've got great food there. Last time I went there, I had French toast. It was rocking. Admittedly, I had way too much syrup on it, but that's my fault because I... Sugar! Whee! I'm repeating what I said in previous videos, but if you do have the chance to go to a gathering, go to one, you meet new people. Meet people you already know. People in real life are... Some of them tend to be the same, others tend to be different. I'm probably either... I don't know which one I am. Depends. Come and find out. Come and say, hey, Andy. Fed Square, noon, Dolomite Cafe on Sunday, the 8th of February. Hope to see you there. And regardless of when you see this video, whether it's before the gathering, after it, or way after the gathering, hope to see you soon. So, hope to see you guys at Fed Square, and thanks for stopping by. Yeah, it is a butter knife.